It's a quite unique story when an artist finds out to live in the very same house of one of his favorite artists from the past. But it gets even more interesting when he creates an art exhibition and his neighbor writes a book about it. That's the case of Constable and Brighton, Something Out of Nothing.
6 months of doing up the place, it was an incredibly dilapidated house. One of our neighbors, Shan Lancaster, popped over and she said, do you realize that this may well be John Constable's house? And we spent the next 2 years investigating this, and eventually we found out that it was.
I'd wanted to write a book about Constable and Brighton ever since I discovered that he'd lived for long periods of his life in the early 1820s in my road. It was such an intriguing thing because nobody knew that Constable had spent any time here that I knew.
Well, after a few years of research along with various Constable experts, we actually believe that he painted at the back of the house. There's a little painting that shows the view up Little Preston Street, so we think that is probably where he painted.
Like a lot of people who come to Brighton for the first time, he was just shocked by how in your face it was and how busy and bustling and vulgar and all the people mixed up. But gradually, over the 4 years, he became more than reconciled to the place. And when you read his letters from the end of the period, he's referring to it as the dear old sea. And he came back many times and sent his children to school here.
Quite uptight before he comes to Brighton. I mean, he's always quite uptight, but he's particularly uptight before he comes to Brighton. And then, due to his wife's illness, they come to Brighton and they have probably his first holiday ever. And so he starts relaxing and he starts enjoying some aspects of his success. And he makes these very quick, almost abstract paintings. And that's why we enjoy them so much.
Fascinating thing I found when I started looking at this was that Turner, the very famous artist of the period, was in Brighton at exactly the same time as Constable. Every year, I think, that Brighton had Constable living on the west side here by Regency Square, we had Turner up on the east side because he used to stay with Lord Egremont, who had a house in what we now know as Kemp Town, and they were painting and drawing equally prolifically from opposite ends of the town, but they were tremendous rivals. But these little drawings were so special that by the end of the period, there are lots of letters from friends and family saying, please can we borrow your Brighton sketches? My wife is ill was a lovely one, and he said, I'll send her a box of my Brighton sketches, maybe the fresh air will cheer her up.
The quality of the way in which the clouds move from Shoreham towards Brighton and on, you can still see that today, these sort of shelf clouds as they sweep across the landscape, and that is something that Constable really focused on, and it changed his painting radically between 1824 and 1828.